Hi, I'm Dazza Greenwood, a research scientist here in the Human Dynamics Group, and this is a talk about one of the newer research areas of the group, which is applying Sandy Pentland's approach of computational social science to the law. It's something that we call computational legal science, and functionally, what it's about is taking what is customarily known as the law and legal studies and applying empirical, quantitative, computational, if you will, techniques. So you could ask, what is the law? Is it the combined knowledge and wisdom of your culture expressed through statutes? Is it nuanced processes of information-intensive narratives? Or is it, in fact, data? What we're hypothesizing is that it can be looked at as data. And when you look at the law as data, increasingly, what is possible is a deeper insight into what the law is and how it relates to other social and other systems. Very important to note that legal documents already are being published as data, accessible through an API in a structured format, such as XML, JSON, tabularized, and once that happens more regularly and in more expected formats, that literally the same methods, the same techniques of statistical analysis, predictive modeling, and deep data-driven insights into what the law is and how it relates to business systems, social systems, economic systems, the systems of your life can be visualized and acted upon. So causing the law to be actionable is one of the aims of computational legal science. So let's take a look more deeply at how this could work. So start, for example, with a statute. Massachusetts General Laws, Chapter 66A, for example. That's our Fair Information Practices Act. That can and is expressed in business-to-business contracts. For example, when the state health and human service agencies have large contracts with vendors for healthcare and clinic and CMS reimbursements, they absolutely have within those contracts Chapter 66A compliance to make sure that all the individuals who have data in those systems have a right to see the data, a right to get a copy of the data, a right to dispute the accuracy of the data, the basic set in the B2B contracts. Go down one level and what you have is the capability to express these key rules and expectations as terms of service for app developers and service providers that are integrating with online services in the context, say, of these state systems. Go down one more level, and you can see terms of service that the end user, the patient, the person going to a clinic, a person seeking health and human service benefits, can click on a mobile app, on a web browser, any kind of service online, and now be within that fabric of the law that's integrated at a business, legal, and technical level, and go down one further level, and what you are capable of architecting is an integration of those rules right down to the individual permissions that are granted by those people themselves. So the permission, for example, to see part of their medical record or consent to give access to, say, a clinical report or some payment or to allow someone to be authorized as their delegate for some transaction, for example. These living law, kind of, or liquid data-driven law instruments that can be massively scalable, you can think of as interlateral. You apply a standard, and just as with the internet itself, you can come into these fabrics of rules. Physics is probably the most interesting capability of computational legal science. What is physics? You could say, what Wikipedia says, it's the natural science that involves the study of matter and its motion through space and time, along with related concepts such as energy and force. Legal physics you could think of as the social science that involves the study of legal matters through time and space. And other related concepts such as, well, if not energy, maybe resource allocation. And if not force, maybe more like enforceability. These can all be expressed as data. They can be visualized, they can be predicted, and they can be rendered actionable for your business, for your government, for your life. So here's a little bit of overview of this new research approach here in the Human Dynamics Lab that we're exploring under the general umbrella of computational legal science and the cutting edge of that, which we're starting to call legal physics. For more information, take a look at the group's website, which is hd.media.mit.edu, or a site that we've just set up to get more feedback on this concept of legal physics, and it's just at http://legalphysics.org.